Hello everyone, welcome back. I hope you all are fine and safe. So in this video we are going to see the solution of vocabulary and grammar part of chapter number 4, unit 4, A Truly Beautiful Mind, and it is written by Isaac Asimov. So number 1, rectify the errors in the passages. So number 1, first of all I am going to read the passage, then we will see errors and corrections. So passage number 1, the headmaster once told Einstein's father, if what Einstein chose as a profession wouldn't matter, therefore he will never make a success at everything. Einstein began to learn to play the violin at the age of 6, therefore his mother wanted him to. So now the errors and corrections are A, once, the correct spelling is O-N-C-E, once. B, if, that. C, therefore, because. D, everything, anything. E, to learn, learning. F, therefore, because. Now, paragraph number 2. Einstein was deeply shaken by the extent of the destruction. This time he was writing a public missive for the United Nations. In it he proposed the form of a government, of a world government, like the letter to Roosevelt. This one made no impression, but over the next decade Einstein got ever more evolved in politics. So now errors and corrections are A, deep, deeply. B, was writing, wrote. C, for, to. D, from, formation. E, like, unlike. F, impression, impact. Now, question number 2. Fill in the blanks choosing the correct words given in the bracket. Write the answers only. Now, number 1, options are prolonged, moved, previous, felt. Paragraph is, the dash here, Albert's parents had dash to Milan, and dash their son with relatives. After dash discussion, Einstein got his wish to continue his education in Switzerland. So answers are A, previous, B, moved, C, left, D, prolonged. Number 2, options are private, right, while, unraveling. So paragraph is, dash, Einstein was solving the most difficult problem in the physics. His dash life was dash. Albert had wanted to marry Mileva dash after finishing his studies. So now answers are A, while, B, private, C, unraveling, and D, right. Now let's move to another question. Question number 3. Choose the correct articles, conjunctions, or preposition from the brackets and complete the following passage. So passage number 1 is, Albert Einstein went dash high school dash Munich dash Einstein's family has moved dash he was 15 months old dash scored good marks in dash every subject. So your answers are A, 2, B, N, C, where, D, when, E, and, F, almost. Now paragraph number 2, dash Einstein died dash 1955 dash the age dash 76. He was celebrated dash a visionary dash world citizen. So your answers are A, when, B, in, C, at, D, of, E, as, F, end. Now next question is, punctuate the following paragraph. So first of all I'm going to read the answers, read the question and then answer. Number 1, at the urging of a colleague, Einstein wrote a letter to the American president Franklin D. Roosevelt on 2nd of August 1939, in which he warned a single bomb of this type exploded in a pot might very well destroy the whole pot together with some of the surrounding territory. So now see what we have to do. It makes no sense if I read the answer. So just read the answer and also just watch the commas and the inverted commas, colon and capital lettering and then full stop I have put in the paragraph. So just watch it carefully, okay? Read it thoroughly and write your answers. Same with the paragraph number 2. Okay, it makes no sense if I read the read the passage just by reading it, you won't get the punctuations, okay? So just watch it carefully, read it thoroughly and write your answers carefully with all the punctuations correctly, okay? Now let's move to question number 5. Convert the following into indirect speech. So number 1, looking at his newborn sister Maja, he is said to have said, "Fine, but where are her wheels?" A headmaster once told his father that what Einstein chose as a profession wouldn't matter because he will never make a success at anything. So the answer is, looking at Einstein's newborn sister Maja, father mentioned "fine" and asked where were her wheels. A headmaster once told his father that what Einstein chose as a profession wouldn't matter because he will never make a success at anything. Now, number 2, wrote Einstein, "How happy and proud I shall be when we both have brought our work on relativity to a victorious conclusion." Your answer is, Einstein exclaimed how happy and proud he would be when they both had brought their work on relativity to a victorious conclusion. Now, question number 6. Do as directed. Number 1, Albert had wanted to marry Mileva right after finishing his studies, but his mother was against it. Use though. Albert wanted to marry Mileva right after finishing his studies, but his mother was against it. Just add though in the beginning, okay? Though Albert wanted to marry, okay? I forgot to mention though. So just write Albert wanted to marry Mileva right after finishing his studies, but his mother was against it, okay? So this is the correct answer. Now, number 2, when the Nazis came to power in Germany in 1933, Einstein emigrated to the United Nations. Make it simple. So turn into simple, okay? So the correct answer is, Einstein emigrated to the United Nations after the Nazis came to power in Germany in 1933. Now, question number 3. E is equals to mc square is the world's famous formula. So your answer is, no other formula, you have to change the degree. So your answer is, no other formula in the world is as famous as E is equals to mc square. Now, question number 4. Einstein was deeply shaken by the extent of the destruction. Add a question tag. So your answer is, Einstein was deeply shaken by the extent of the destruction. Wasn't, then put comma and then add wasn't he, then put question mark. Now, question number 5. At the urging of a colleague, Einstein wrote a letter to the American president. Turn the sentence into complex. So your answer is, Einstein wrote a letter to the American president due to urging of a colleague. Now the writing part. Question number 1 is, you celebrated your 14th birthday on a grand scale. All your near and dear ones were present. Write a diary to express your feelings. So I just put the title 14th birthday celebration, then mention day and date of your birthday and the timing you are writing your diary. Then, dear diary, I am very happy today and I have no words to express my feelings. On my 14th birthday, we went to a party in the restaurant. I was too excited. I invited all my friends and relatives to my birthday party. Everyone has bought a wonderful gift for me. We cut the cake, which was very delicious. We danced, sang songs, and also played games. The dinner was delicious too. Me and my all friends enjoyed the party and danced a lot. This was my best birthday ever. This was my best birthday I have ever had. Make the correction. I have ever had. Good night. So this was the diary writing. Then number two, prepare a report on your visit to Science City to be displayed on your school notice board. So I have written this report and it is represented by head girl or a head boy of your school. Okay. And if your teacher says make some changes, do changes according to that. But this is written from the perspective of head girl or a head boy. So put the title, visit to Science City, then mention the place and date. Then the body part comes. St. Joseph's School, Surat had organized a one-day Science City education tour for class 9 to 12th standard students. So the purpose of this visit was to promote and enhance students' understanding of the culture of the science and technology, and to foster a spirit of science, scientific inquiry, and creativity among the students. The trip to Science City was a wonderful experience with full of knowledge of science, math, biological, and much more, making science simple and interesting. A visit to an auditorium to Beyond Planet, Earth Museum, IMAX 3D movies, Hall of Space, Hall of Science, Mars ride, etc. were very exciting for students and really helps them understanding basic science. In this visit, around 88 students visit Science City along with 7 faculties and the principal of, okay, make correction, principal of St. Joseph School, head boy or girl, okay. So this was the solution of vocabulary and grammar part of chapter number 4, A Truly Beautiful Mind. So if you have any doubt, query or suggestion, let me know in the comment section. I will see you in the next video with a new chapter. Till then, bye-bye. Take care.